Hey guys, it's your boy Kerberz, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool crew. In this episode, I have a game against Manchester City to kick everything off. In fact, I think I may have both Manchester clubs in this episode. Because I know I have Man United this month as well. I think I do, actually. I think I have both Manchester clubs. City first, then United. We will see. Manchester City first, though, at Anfield. Let's do it.
Liverpool getting it right at the back.
Best defensive team in the league. Unfortunately, I've conceded 3 goals.
What makes this team so hard to beat is the fact that everybody works hard.
That's not here.
Starts at the front with the strikers.
The most important.
Big reshuffle for Liverpool.
Scoring goals, kicking ass. And I'm taking.
Klein starts with David Alaba as the fullbacks.
And they're keeping wearing fucking pants. So.
In central midfield. And the strike force.
I have to win this match on principle.
With Divock Origi.
Keepers should not wear pants ever.
Manchester City's lineup.
You should not be wearing pants.
He's fit again. Douglas Costa starts, looking to continue his great form.
That should be a rule. Yeah, they walk green.
Celebrations reflect that.
Black. The supporters are going crazy. The hard way. For the team.
He took the chance with absolute precision, Alan.
Wasn't an easy one either, that Martin, but he made it look so.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. Fernando.
His sixth goal of the season, if I'm not mistaken.
Kyle Walker, got the right back missing for the visiting team today, Alan. He's suspended.
Previously in the last episode. Don't throw him away with the top goal scorer.
Great defending there, stopping that attack.
The most is 7, which is managing. And Origi's only one behind.
A dangerous position now. Just a heavy touch, the opposition can take the ball away. Shot on!
Ooh!
In spectacular start.
I was fully expecting it. I was ready to say goal. I thought that was going to go in. I just didn't catch it right. He catches that right, flies past Rulli, and it's 2-0. Ah! That's a shame.
Zabaleta. Nice return pass. Good defending.
Sewell.
In midfield, they got it back via an interception. David Silva was spotted. Could be dangerous.
Manning.
Oh, he's through.
Rigi. Renato Sanchez. It's 2-0. Thank you very much.
That really has given them much more of a basis for the rest of this match. The goalkeeper's heroes or zero. Zero against his name here.
Well, he left his post. He's outside the 6-yard box, and it was a poor decision from him.
Fifth goal in the league for Renato Sanchez.
Let's widen the margin here.
See what I mean about goals being more spread out this season? Renato Sanchez has 5, which is only 2 away from 7, which is what he scored in all of last season. This is game 10 or 11. I think it might 12 at the latest, but we're not even halfway through the season, and he's almost.
And here comes the counter attack.
This level with what he scored last season. As Coutinho makes it 3-0 and pretty much finishes off City here and now.
Well, a little look of celebration, but inwardly he must be buzzing.
Really, no reason to do that. He pretty much put it on a play for Coutinho. Pep Pep's going to be pissed. His defence were asleep. Not for the first time.
Good to have.
Yeah. Bad day for Guardiola.
Eliakim Mangala.
One of those, I suppose. It's just one of those.
A timely challenge. Nathaniel Klein. Origi. They just seem to wind him up, push him out there, and he just runs and runs till the final whistle goes.
Yeah, he does. The
back seem
to run out with this point.
Matos just can't get it silver clear. Going for a throw, but he'll play it.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Into the box for Origi! Straight. Sanchez.
Short passes, but they're keeping the ball.
Firmino! Mane!
Stealthily into scoring position here. Not picked up, and they paid a heavy price for that.
Fair play, Sadio, fair play. In the right place at the right time. The
keeper, quite rightly, is disgusted with his defenders because they've just not helped him out there.
Goal of the season for Sadio Mane.
4-0. Stones. Well, no shots at all so far for Manchester City.
Like I said, not running away with it.
Here. I think they've just
it's
all
not like
lost
he's
the courage.
18. He's at 8.
Aguero looking to get the ball forward here. Manchester City.
That goal.
Well, this is how this team can play.
Just Rubius. Now back to.
Shots on here.
That was good.
Keeper couldn't get down quickly.
He was back to where he was behind Origi before the match, but yeah, behind Mane before the match, but Origi's like, nah, I'm gonna score for another goal. Now he's back to one behind.
Well, they've got a substitute coming on.
Man City are making a substitution 9 before half time. They're bringing on Icardi for Aguero. I don't think that's the problem, Pep. I really don't. Unless Aguero is injured.
Chance for something to happen because there's three.
But, I didn't see Sergio. Oh, he did. He is injured.
Can you believe?
I didn't see him go down to any of you. He must have gone down in like build up to that goal. I still haven't changed Courtois' number. I'll do it after this match. Because I keep
really
forgetting to do it.
Very one-sided first half, and the
he should have
wrong end of that scoreline has got to show a bit of backbone now. Manchester City are the side trailing here, despite having more possession. Look at those stats.
Yeah, it's quite incredible, really. They've dominated possession and dominated the match, but doesn't show for anything.
Stones does enough, but only to get it out to Coutinho. Sanchez!
Excellent header, probably deserved a bit better from it.
Yeah, he's one of the best headers of the ball in this league.
That was a good opportunity. He'd get another goal.
For Manchester City, the substitute is ready.
Renato, but couldn't.
A quick note for your diary. Make a note of this particular.
The next game is against Manchester United.
Presentation of the Premier League.
I'm going to Manchester in that game. To go to Old Trafford.
Yeah, I've had a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well.
The cross is blocked there by the defender.
We're having. I'm hosting one Manchester club that. Very next game, I'm going to Manchester to play Diarra.
On the attack now.
Diarra main away, I should say, because he's playing Manchester. But it's two in the Premier.
Not a good challenge by the defender. Great chance.
Maybe I should have gone for myself with Mane.
It's a good idea.
Instead of cutting,
find this supporting
cutting it back. Coutinho,
Manchester City's
whip it in.
They're playing Watford in the next match. I think they're going to win.
Oh yeah, bring on Raheem, the
spotted that
scumbag
well.
Sterling. Let him drink it in. Let him
back again
experience this domination.
Still 20 minutes to go. Here's Sterling.
Yeah, enjoying that. Yeah.
Let's try and get the ball back now. There's good progress with this attack.
I think I hear faint rumblings of Sterling. What's the score chat?
Chooses to punch here, the goalkeeper. Good technique. And here's the shot.
Oh, I wish that chant was in the game. I really wish it was.
Liverpool winning. Their fans are singing.
Well, it's been the perfect day, really, for the Reds. And there's not too
they
long
have
left
chants
in, this match
in the game. Like, they have songs. Never Walk Alone. Fields of Anfield Road. But, you know, they don't chant for
well,
the players.
That
like, I don't hear
quickly.
Teeny. Song, I don't hear a Rigi song.
A throw in.
I'm here.
Kevin De Bruyne.
I'm showering abuse at that scumbag egg wearing the Man City number 7 shirt.
I did think that this would be one of the tightest games we've seen, Alan, but.
I mean, come on.
It's extraordinary, it's gone the other way.
Yeah, it has. It has.
Yeah, that's part of
the stadium is quite surprised by that.
If you're going to be realistic, you need to add that into the game as well.
Full stretch. Corner. We've got 8 more minutes of the 90. And there's the interception. Looking to get the ball forward here.
Hey! Go all the way, Roberto. Go all the way. No, I'm not losing this. I have to score from you now after you took the ball. Ah! Damn it! Of course.
Please give a round of applause for today's man of the match.
Good one. 2 minutes left. That's added time. Kevin De Bruyne. Looked very good indeed, but the.
There's a full time whistle. Oh, one Manchester club down. And the Nick. And the other Manchester her club are next.
Liverpool 5, Manchester City 0. So what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table remain Liverpool.
That was the 11th game of the
season. In second, Tottenham Hotspur with 25 points. In third, Chelsea with 24 points. In fourth, West Ham United with 18 points. In fifth, Everton with 13 points. In sixth, Leicester City with 16 points. In seventh, Bournemouth.
Apologies, this is my third video in a row.
Climbing the table are Crystal Palace with 15 points.
Your man wants a
bottom of the table, Newcastle United with 5 points. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Norwich City with 6 points.
Let me guess.
Third bottom, Aston Villa with 11 points. Fourth bottom, West Bromwich Albion with 11 points.
Okay, Fernandez
bottom,
and
Swansea City with 11 points.
The goalkeeper. Dude, you're not needed. If you're not gonna sign a contract, I'll find people who will sign contracts. I'll replace his Fernandez with this Mercier guy. Hey, if I have to. I won't have to, but I would. My fans. No. Your career at Liverpool is over, motherfucker. That you signed your own release slip, or your not release slip. I'm gonna list you for transfer. Throw away any evaluation that you might have. That's just because you're not gonna sign a new contract. That just means you're both gone. You can come down. Before I forget again, going to kit numbers so I don't forget to do it. Number one. There we go. Sort it. $2.6 million. Thank you very much. I will enjoy having that in the bank. I don't need it, but I'll enjoy having it. And the other fella is a cam, so here we just chilling here. There he is. Loaned out for 1 year. I don't care where you are. Charlton Athletic. Sorry, Charlton. I'm recalling this guy and selling his ass. Yes. He won't sign a contract. Well, let's see him play the game against me. I have a way of getting my way one way or a fucking nutter. If you're not gonna play for me long term, then you get out. I replaced Chen. I replaced East Carius. I can replace you two. Low life. I don't even need to replace the goalkeeper. I already have three. This is a blessing in disguise. But for the cam, I can replace you with any guy off the street. Sorry, LaFont, the game is too big to play you in. Because I have a reputation to uphold against Manchester United. See, there's this undefeated streak I have against them. Never been beaten against them. And so, yeah. I don't care about Arsenal and Crystal Palace. Why the hell should I? Have to get a new bottle of water after this episode's over. What am I currently drinking from is almost empty. Not sure why I'm sharing this with you guys, but it's good to share. There are some things. Even though I know you guys don't care.
Hi there, everyone. Old Trafford is the venue for our match today.
Who cares? Who cares where we are? We know where we are. I don't even know we play in Old Trafford.
Well, it's Liverpool against Manchester United.
If except for away.
To put them in front. Oh, that's embarrassing.
Ah, Origi. It's the second time you've done that. Don't worry. I don't hold a grudge, but damn, man. Damn.
Kane. He'll need to try and get the ball back now. Not rushing it here. Moving from one side to the other.
Oh, that's a foul. No. Book that, man.
Free kick with no sign of the card. Maybe
hello?
To make sure
you're not going
to
book him.
Not made a rod for his own back with an early booking.
Wow. Piss off. Put on your red...
David Alaba.
Man United jersey. Daft cunt.
If he can get the ball here for his goal kick. Well, there's no doubt that West Ham United have been playing some great football this season and certainly punching above their weight.
Well, I don't know if they can sustain this kind of form and keep in a Champions Cup position. I have to doubt it, but they've been good value so far.
Ross Barkley. Pogba. Griezmann. Ross Barkley.
Barkley. Pogba. Shaw.
Good challenge.
Hey! I won the ball, but then...
competitive nature of this game, that time.
Immediately.
It's Jesse Lingard. Trying to stretch the opposition, using the wider areas here. He could do a better cross than that, I think. And it was easy to cope with. Good play until they got that challenge in. Shaw. Crisp defending there.
Hey, Renato Sanchez.
Good forward play from
them. Sorry, man.
That's a see you situation, and on he goes.
Oh, it was Nathaniel Klein of all people. Why was it him? No offense to Nathaniel, but come on! Really? Of all people in that position. You don't want your right back!
They want to extend today.
It'd be like Man United being in a position to score and having only Darmian up there.
Clear his lines. Ross Barkley. Coutinho gives away.
I can guarantee you, no Man United fan would want that in a crucial moment.
For Manchester United,
like, okay.
They'll be facing Napoli away.
They wouldn't mind if they were comfortable and it was in that situation. But a 0-0 at a crucial moment in a crucial game, guarantee you they wouldn't. They would want anyone else. They'd probably prefer Mourinho.
Onto the attack now. Comes in strongly. Stopped him.
Like I said, no offense to Nathaniel Klein, but he has one goal in four seasons, and it was like against Crystal Palace or something like that. I'm not sure about that.
Cross could come in.
It was it's one of three teams. It was either Crystal Palace, Southampton, Sunderland. Sorry, four teams. Sunderland or. I don't know why, but I have this odd feeling United were, for some reason, come to my mind when I think of Nathaniel Klein goals. I don't know why. He has no goals against Manchester United in real life, to my knowledge. Definitely doesn't have any for Liverpool. Well, that's for sure. I can't remember him scoring any for Southampton or Crystal Palace.
All in midfield, well read by.
But maybe he didn't, I just don't remember it. But here he comes again! Nathaniel, where are you going?
He's gonna try his luck!
He's gonna win the corner, but.
Get their noses in front from the corner.
You're probably saying, why didn't you pass? There are players all around me. Where the fuck was I supposed to pass it to? The guys in the red shirts. In this game, those are not my players. I'm in the black.
Well, that is half time, and the score is 0-0 here. Well, he's been in the game, hasn't he? That's the best we can say for him. But not everything he's tried has come off.
He worked hard enough, but just didn't come off for him. But he's got another half.
No, half time. Need a goal here in the second half. Can't let my perfect record against Manchester United go for a 0-0 draw.
Ross Barkley. Griezmann.
And need be, I'll go all attacking.
He's held off the challenge there and kept possession. Now Kane.
I mean, need to make a substitution or two.
They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this
Darmian.
Attack.
Easy for Courtois. There was no United players near him.
excellent run. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
This with the Origi. Firmino. Mane! Ah! Oh.
Corner now for Liverpool. Here comes the replay.
What reflex is there from the keeper?
Mane, get there! Ah!
Allen. And it's been an hour of very good football here. We've still got 30 more minutes to go, and I'm sure we're going to enjoy that as well. Throw in for Liverpool. Here's Renato
Sanchez. Play out wide to Coutinho.
Good forward.
Mane. Penalty!
Needed to time that tackle.
Penalty! Fuck off, you daft bias! His cunt!
Shots on here. That shot's blocked very quickly.
Firmino. Foul? Of course not. Are you incapable of calling fouls? Or is it only for Manchester United that you turn into a complete blind twat? Sayo Mane, 101, get it! That's what I'm talking about!
But it's a good goal past them, and the opposing manager will be worried now because his team were basing their game on shutting out the opposition. Well, that's failed, and the manager of the team that scored will be delighted. He'd be wondering whether it would come. Well, it has come belatedly, but it might be enough. Well, it is a good performance, this. They've got a goal to show for it. They're really giving themselves a chance in this game against opposition where they wouldn't be expecting to win the game. They would expect it to be a very difficult match.
I think so, but
it took 70 minutes when I got to the whole break the deadlock.
It's evenly matched.
And now Man United have to come out of their shell. Do they want to get anything from this game?
Tremendous understanding from these players. Read the play well to intercept.
I have to be careful because this referee is probably going to give anything and everything now for Manchester United to get free kicks and penalties if I let them get too close. Ali.
That's a good challenge.
Penalty? Of course not.
Manchester United's chance.
He can just trip me. He slide me. He can do whatever the fuck he wants. He can kill my team.
It's in. Fine moment for
Nathaniel Klein scored.
A grip on the game now. They're two ahead.
Man United, you should quit now. A man who hasn't scored since season one just scored a goal against you.
By name, but he's got an
that tells you a lot.
As this shows.
Now, only one player in the starting 11 has not got at least one goal this season.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
Over to you, Nicholas Sewell. That is you. You're the only player. Only outfield player with not at least one goal this season.
The circumstances.
And Nathaniel Klein scored his first goal since season one.
And on the clock, eight more minutes.
And if it was, our goal was against Man United, he's continued his run against them. He's going again! Tripped by Jones, of course, because Jones can just foul me wherever the fuck he wants! Of course that's a foul! Of course it's a yellow! You might as well send him off, you blind cunt!
Yellow card to their name and that player.
You couldn't make it more obvious that you're a fucking biased prick!
Well, they're in a good position here. It was nicely worked until that point.
Go on, Sadio.
Broke down. And now they've got to try and regain possession.
Mane. It's a Dele Alli! 3-0! Fuck you, Man United! Fuck your bias, referee! You still lost! No matter how many bias referees I've had to fight off, they've never worked! So stop doing it, you daft cunt!
That's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway. Fourth official has indicated 3 more minutes. And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle. Attacking now. David Alaba. And that's the...
A beautiful 3-0 win. Sadio Mane, Nathaniel Clyne and Dele Alli with the goals. And Manchester United can go fuck themselves.
Arsenal 1.
Oh, Crystal Palace beat Arsenal.
Aston Villa 1. Newcastle United 1.
I was expecting a scoreline, I'd say, at the very least.
Everton 3. Southampton 1. Leicester City.
Don't worry, Lafont. You can play that game against PSV. No one cares about that game anything.
Swansea City 1. Tottenham Hotspur 1.
That game will be simmed off.
Manchester City 2.
Green. Because, of course, it's irrelevant.
City 2. Let's have a look at what those results.
And in the next episode, I'll have games against.
With 36.
One second, Watford second, and Leorient.
With 26.
Might be the last time I play Leorient because it looks like they're going to be relegated from the Football League, which means they won't be in FIFA next
Everton
season.
With 21 points.
And next.
In fifth
season, it may as well be next season.
With 18 points.
Next FIFA.
In sixth, climbing the table are Crystal Palace.
In which
with
case,
18 points. In seventh, rising up the table are Sunderland.
That is unless they add the conference.
Falling are West Ham
to FIFA
with 18
again.
Points. Bottom of the
they
table.
They took it out and it hasn't been back points. Since. It's been gone since table, like 2004.
Norwich City with 9 points.
I have no idea where they took it out.
Moving down are West Bromwich Albion with 11 points.
Wait. Fourth bottom. I mean, those of you player play Football Manager, you'll points. Still have Lane Orient because that goes all the way down to non-league, like lower than the fucking conference. So, yeah. Anyway, that is not here nor there. That'll be the next episode. So, until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.